sir.
I'm Snapchatting. What are you doing?
I'm Periscoping you.
Whoa, I'm Periscoping you, Snapchatting.
It's happening.
Oh my God.
What do you say?
I'd say, hey, brands, you better brand it up because it's brand time, baby.
Jason, do you want to give a commentary on the presidency of the United States?
On the presidency of the United States?
I mean, what, you have something you want to say?
Yes. Don't vote out of fear.
Oh.
Vote out of hope.
Okay, right on. Hey, oh yeah, I forgot to mention you're live.
Sorry about that, bro.
There we go.
Oh, that smells good.
Oh, geez Louise. So what did we get? Tuck away?
So, the issue with monetization schemes is that you can't leverage a lot of your platform.
The issue is that you have no
potential.
Fucking pizza dough stuffed
or
in your
brand
face.
Optimization.
So you're busy talking about brand optimization.
And when you,
what you
those
need
efficiencies
to
across
swear to Christ, you're gonna get so much pizza dough right in your pie hole.
Yeah.
You know why they call
exactly.
it a pie hole?
Because that's
I'm gonna
pie
cram
goes.
All that
right.
pie up in that hole.
Uh-huh. By pie he means his wiener.
Right, and by hole I mean right, so anyway. Okay.
Just spell it out.
Yeah, that's what you do.
Yeah, this is 6th Street all the time.
Training Dr. Pepper! $1 shots,
$2 bills. Flaming Dr. Peppers. Pete's dueling piano bars. You know we're almost to what?
What?
You know what you gotta get?
Hoax! Death Metal Pizza Girl!
Yeah.
You know you need that!
Oh, this pizza's so good that it lands. Down.
Okay, we don't need to bring this up.
Face down on 6th Street where a million people have trampled their feet.
Yeah.
You will pick it up. You will
we'll buy it there.
Up, you will eat then... it and you will get the flu. And you
yeah.
will have ER like 3
okay,
days later.
Yes. All right. Yes, that might have happened.
That's
not... fine.
You only eat it because you don't
what?
Have another dollar.
Wait, do you want to get off 6th Street?
No. Are we? Well, where are we going? Where are we going?
No. Apparently, we're not
dude,
going
double
there.
Pizza is this way,
we're
and then up. The next block over is where we're headed.
Oh, okay.
So it's like the best of both worlds. You get the double pizza.
You know where I went on my
anniversary?
Honeymoon?
Where?
On my literal honeymoon.
Yeah. You went to Hoax Death Metal Pizza?
Devil motherfucking pizza.
No shit.
Yes.
All right, here we go.
Hello, beautiful people. It's one of my favorites, next to the Babaloo Cigar Company, is Hoax Death Metal Pizza. Let's get up in that. Let's get this in our lives.
Hi, guys.
Hi, how's it going?
Let me get a pepperoni.
It's going to be $5.
What do you want? Pepperoni? What do you want?
White cheese.
Yes,
all together?
Yes. Do you have a cheese?
Yeah.
One cheese, two pepperoni.
Okay.
Wait, you have something with jalapenos on it?
Yeah, we got some hamburger with jalapenos and we got a pepperoni with jalapenos.
Pepperoni with jalapenos?
Oh, or just one?
Yeah, we're gonna get three. One cheese.
One cheese, one pepperoni with jalapenos.
Now we're talking.
Take the helm. Hey everybody, what's going on? My name is Jose McGillicuddy. We're here at South by Southwest. We're at Hoax Death Metal Pizza. In all sense. You can't see that.
Sorry.
no-go for you, Justin?
Giving you death metal cinematography on your pizza.
Good. That's a lot of... Let's go!
Wait, I didn't get a pizza?
I asked you!
No, you handed me the phone! It said, go!
I asked you.
You did not.
Oh, really?
Yes!
It's not possible that you just didn't hear it?
I'm sorry.
It isn't.
Whatever, let's go.
Here, you can have half my pizza. I might have ruined it with cheese. Justin, you want half this pizza?
No. Go, eat the pizza.
That's smart.
Wait, are you sure?
Yes.
What? No, I don't want a pizza. Of course I mean. Yes, I want a pizza.
Well, that's true. By the way, I think we got a text from Tom.
He said, come crash this motherfucker.
Oh, he did?
Yeah.
Oh, well then hells yeah. We're going to do that. As soon as we get past these laser swords. Oh, shit. This is where the other party was. Dude, let's illegally stream that shit.
Look at that.
Jim Davis?
Where?
Literally right there.
Jeff Bryant? No. That would have been great if it was. Alright, I'm in a bit of a pickle here.
Why?
Because I'm holding this pizza, but I can't eat it because my other hand's holding this. This is the monkey's paw. I wished for pizza, but I lost a hand in order to make it happen.
Everybody knows the Brian 66 pizza story, right?
Oh, jeez. nobody will stop sharing it. Yes, all of the above.
Yes.
It was pretty bad. Oh, hey, did you know that Mashable opened up a hotel?
Well, this is the first time they've not been at a couple of billions, right?
Yeah, that's right. They have always been. Well, that was the place that used to be Emo's.
Yeah, I tried to hit up Homeboy, but he hasn't got back to me.
Who? The guy who conquered the universe? Yeah. Ah. Oh, shit, son. I'm glad that we all made this happen.
Justin, you know the Brian on Sixth Street.
God damn it, don't you just tell everyone, all of you. Yes, I got very, very sick. Yes, the pizza was very, very good. Would I do it again? Yes.
So, we went to Hoax. This was probably, what, 15 years ago?
2001.
Was it 2001?
Mm-hmm.
So, 15 years ago.
Right, that's math. Do you have the directions? We turn it over here, okay.
And we're, Brian and I don't remember where we had been drinking.
Right.
But at the end of the evening, as always, we went to Hoax.
Death Metal Pizza.
Hoax Death Metal Pizza.
Right.
And we waited in line because that's what you had to do.
I don't do lines.
Yeah. We waited in line. Brian ordered some pizza. He received said pizza. Mm. And it immediately fell face down onto the sidewalk of 6th Street.
Now, if you're not familiar, 6th Street is a little bit filthy.
6th Street's like the...
Very busy.
6th Street's like the Bourbon Street of Austin. Brian immediately...
Street had an even filthier Bourbon Street, it would be 6th Street.
Yes. Brian immediately snatched up the pizza and ate it while we are going, no. And he just ate it.
I mean, it was some moves are just instinctual. You can't really control them.
It was really good pizza, right?
Where are we going again?
You should have the text of where the party location is.
How long were you sick? 2 weeks?
A week and a half.
A week and a half.
It was pretty bad.
I can't believe that's so bad. It was gross.
I couldn't believe I had carbon.
I had hoax death metal pizza, not off of the street, on my honeymoon.
All right, can we talk about the President of the United States of America?
Yeah, no.
Wait, we're going in a totally other direction.
Yeah, I was...
It was like a Rainy Street thing.
No,
that's the other way.
Container Bar, Davis.
Yeah, that's us. Oh, no, sorry. No, it's 100% right. We are going 100% the right way. South right here, that's where it is.
Oh, yeah, okay.
Yeah, none of that.
Okay. So we need to get back on Red River Street?
No.
It's down right over there. All right, so anyway, President of the United States of America decides to crash South by Southwest. The Prez calls up his peeps and says, "Prez, peeps, it's me, the Prez." And they said, "Yeah, Prez." And you're like, "You know what I want? I want something authentically Austin." And they say, "Well, how about Austin Institution Karaoke Apocalypse?" He said, "What the fuck is a karaoke apocalypse? Also, my finger's on the trigger, and I might just nuke a republic right now." And they say, "Well, it's a beloved Austin institution where they do live band karaoke." He says, "Live band karaoke? You mean you just pick a name off a list and then you can sing a song and a band will back you up? And like, it's just like you're actually singing in a band?" And they say, "Well, yes, because you actually are singing in a band.
Yes.
For that brief moment, you are the lead singer of an actual band." And he said, "That sounds Austin as hell. I want them to go on immediately after I give a speech." They say, "Well, what's your speech going to be about?" And he says, "I don't know, something about technology, leveling a playing field, access to all, maybe I'll mention encryption or some shit."
Yep.
And they say, "Great, we'll go ahead and do that." And they say, and the president said, "Whatever you do, don't let me finish my speech, go into rando music, and make everyone wait 30 plus minutes until Karaoke Apocalypse takes the stage. Because if that happens, everybody will leave."
Yes.
"And there'll be nobody to perform for."
Correct.
And they say, "We got it, President of the World." They didn't really follow those directives.
No, that didn't happen. So it ended up with Karaoke Apocalypse happening to a crowd of maybe 10. Yeah. Everyone filtered out. And this was after the promise of, after the tease of, we think the president might sing with you guys.
Yeah.
And so they learned, like, so many songs.
Any song that the president might possibly know.
Yeah.
They learned the Humpty Dance. They learned,
I don't know if they learned
Three MCs and One DJ by the Beastie Boys.
High Plains Drifter.
Then they learned Can I Kick It by Tribe Called Quest.
That would be awesome. I would totally do that.
Right?
Yeah.
Can I Kick It?
Yes, you can.
Can I Kick It?
Yes, you can. What the hell's happening over here?
It's a fucking desolate wasteland.
Oh, it's Preacher.
Oh, shit, it is. This is Preacher, like the comic.
He disappeared into this area.
Oh, he's there. Okay, there.
Dude, I hope that show's good.
What was it Max Landis said? Where it's like, "Yeah, man, that's not the Preacher I saw in the comics, but I'll take any Preacher over none."
The real question is, fuck what Max Landis said.
Oh, shit. Shots fired, Max Landis.
I mean, I don't know, man. I saw that last trailer for the movie you made. Like, I don't know how much bloom is still on that rose.
What's the last movie you made?
American Ultra?
No, he directed Me, Him, and Her.
Oh.
And, remember in the 90s, they would make these movies that were usually like LA-centric?
Yeah.
Like, that's where you had it?
Yeah.
So it always used to be like some kind of meditation on like fame and money.
Yeah.
And also because it was like really...
also, it's
like gay stuff, like, you know, that there'd be like a main character who was gay, and
it's like, here are my friends because they were here.
But again, like, this is like 1999 when it was really edgy that gay people existed. Right?
Wait, is this, are we here?
No, we have like another like four blocks away.
Are
we
good?
Yeah.
Did you guys park in Buda? Because I won't need a ride home at that point. I can just walk home.
Okay. Give a hoop.
Oh, Henry. So anyway, that's the trailer.
I don't really know. I'm still trying to find
it. It's
that.
Like that movie from 1999.
You know what movies I think of? Indie films I think of in 99?
Yeah.
Swingers.
Yeah.
That was 95.
No.
Yeah.
No, they were all playing Sega Genesis.
Wait.
NHL 96, right?
Yeah. No, it was, you're right. It wasn't 99.
99 is like Fight Club.
Yeah. 99 is Fight Club.
Fight Club, The
and
Matrix.
The Phantom Menace.
Oh, Jesus Christ. All the same year. Oh, dude, I ran across the clubhouse.
What?
Again, the other, I was chilling shit off to Bryce. We were talking about like unearthed archive stuff.
Yeah.
And I guess at some point we lost permissions to write on that server. So everything's locked in. Nothing's newer than 2014.
Really?
Yeah.
That's kind of cool, though, right?
It is. Especially since, you know, seeing Ernie Cline post a bunch of shit.
I spent the evening hanging out with his ex-wife.
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
We're live on the air.
Yep.
Susan B. Anthony. Willing.
Thank you for... yes.
Sorry.
Thank you for the reminder.
Summers.
Yes.
Wait, what?
Nine Inch Nails.
Wait, Trent Reznor? Oh. Oh, yeah. Dude, that was my favorite thing about having the Playboy channel is that they would show the closer video because they could, because they had tits. But I'm just like, imagine the confused basic cable porn buying motherfucker who's trying to just rub one out. And instead, they're spinning around like a severed pig's head.
And here's Trent Reznor going...
Yeah, man, that was pretty fucked up.
Yeah, so when I lived at...
This is something I wasn't aware of.
What? Oh, you know we had the Playboy channel back in college?
Yeah.
Well, they would have, like, music video countdown shows. And then they would always show that one because they could. And then, you know, it's just awkward because it's like, man, this ain't sexy.
So,
don't show me you're spinning, you know, bacon heads.
Whatever.
Yeah?
It was.
The Playboy channel was always on. Always on.
Yeah. It seems familiar.
Come back, and there were people fucking. And it was like, they always left the TV on, and it
did
was
they do
always
that
on
just
the Playboy.
Make
show.
It awkward.
I think they did it just. Yeah. Really gross.
Yeah, I think they're gonna remember that.
Hotel.
I know, it does say Hoel. First Hoel.
What are we going? Where is... What?
Justin, did you see the advice?
I think we lost Justin. Oh, no, there he is.
Did you see the entry advice?
Back gate?
No. All right, I'm going to let you guys go. Bye, gang.